Getting through your smokes there, Doc.
Oh, plenty more where they came from. Here, have the package.
Oh, Dad.
See, the truth is, you ladies have got them licked. They spend all this money. They put nice bars on all the windows. They hire friendly screws to look after you day and night. And what happens?
We keep them on the hop.
Right. You won't behave yourself. Funny thing, that, isn't it?
Sounds like you're on our side.
What's going on here?
Our smoke goes over, girls.
Have permission to be in here?
No, does it matter?
Well, visitors are restricted to certain areas.
Oh, I see. Very well. See you anon, ladies.
Yeah, drop in any time.
Joyce, you have a visitor. Oh, Monica Ferguson.
Nice of you to come out, Moni.
It's okay. Got a message for you. How you doing?
Oh, you know, nothing changes in here.
No. Things change outside, but...
Yeah?
You can bank on it.
So you saw me Auntie Madge, then?
Yes, into love. Sure took a load off her mind, seeing me. Got a match?
Oh, yeah. Did you try that little shop I told you about?
Yeah. They're very cooperative. Mention your name and, all doors open. Got a whole bunch of goodies for the old girl.
Oh, glad to hear it. How's Fred?
Oh, yeah. All right.
You'll be going away on a holiday, you know, when your money comes through from your shop.
Pretty soon.
Well, good luck to you and thanks for seeing me, Auntie.
It's okay. Give me love to be, you know.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Bruce? Blossom. No, listen. I'm at the Bonanza Motel with this guy, and he's got a Roland Merc that a choker wars. I think 6-7 grand. Yeah, well, that's what I thought. The old routine, eh? All right, then, look, I'll keep him occupied till you get here. Shouldn't be any problem. Yeah, what? The Bonanza Motel, room 403. Right. Okay, Mum, now you look after yourself and do exactly what the doctor says, right? Okay, bye. Mum's not well.
Oh, dear.
Oh, Fred, you give me goosebumps all over. Come to Mama.
Oh, Blossom.
Got a load on them.
Too right. I said to my Bronwyn, you come down and help me. But would she?
What do you expect? Nobody cares for anybody.
Fancy saying charity begins at home.
Don't talk to me about charity. A friend of mine, the only friend I had, was killed by a charity last night.
You don't say.
Good as. They wanted to split us up. Horry wasn't having any. Let them keep their charity, he said.
Oh, a gentleman friend.
I don't know what they thought we'd get up to.
Oh, don't tell me you was past it.
I'm not that old. Neither is he. Neither was he. Oh, but he was sick. He needed me. So we went down to the park. In the morning. Dead.
Oh, that is a shame.
Have a drink.
Oh, no, thanks, love. I'll be getting on. I'd go round if I was you. Tell them what happened and watch them squirm. Good luck.
Take your hands off me.
I wouldn't spit on your charity now.
Well, are you drunk?
What if I am? It's keeping me warm, which is more than you did for my poor Polly.
But you wouldn't stay.
I know your lot. A life and death mean nothing to you. It's all rules and regulations, and we've got to be grateful. If the Lord Jesus was down here, he'd have a few things to say.
Oh, madam, you're being most unfair. Won't you come inside and have some soup?
With hymns for sweets? No, thank you.
Please, please let us help you.
Oh, leave me alone. I'll show you what you can do with your help.
Oh dear.
Now you can smell the night air.
Oh. Well, go and have a drink with Peter. Do what you like.
I can't see the harm.
Don't you get enough of his smart theorizing at work?
I'm sorry, I found her rather interesting.
Oh, yes, you would. I mean, much more intellectual than what you get around here.
Oh, don't be silly, Meg.
Listen, all I know is that our friend Clements is up to something. He's got a smile like a shark and about the same interest in people.
Oh, that's rubbish. You've absolutely no right to say that. The man's an academic, Meg. They tend to sound like that. You can't... Have I said something amusing?
Anyone could string you along now, couldn't they?
Could they? I don't know.
He's on to us, you know.
Possibly. Well, so what? You don't think he's shocked, do you? You should see the way they go on at universities, my God.
Yes, well, I wouldn't know about that, would I? I mean, I'm just a dumb screw.
Egg. Egg, stop it, please.
I'm sorry. Why don't you give us a kiss?
There's been a mistake.
You're right. Now open this door.
Oh, my God, that's my husband.
You're what?
Oh, you better let him in if he gets angry, you know.
He sounds bloody angry already.
So you're the little weasel, are you? You shameless bitch. How could you?
He seduced me. He offered me money.
Please, I didn't know. I'll make it up to you. She didn't say.
Make it up to me? Oh, just... For all the shame and the heartbreak?
Just leave me alone, eh? I'm terribly sorry this happened.
I think I'll have to teach you a serious lesson, my friend.
Here. Oh, wait. Wait. Look. If I give you all this, we can forget it all happened, eh?
You're trying to buy me off?
Right. What do you say?
I'm not a man of violence by nature.
No, of course you're not.
All right, take your things and blow. While my good wife gets herself decent. And remember, I never forget a face, my friend. I am, but so let's go out and eat. And Mr. Campbell and Mr. Hines are all
very
well.
No, I don't want to. I'm not in the mood. I don't want people staring at us and saying, look at that nice young man taking his mother out for a treat.
Oh, that's pathetic. I really do hope you enjoy yourself when you go on like this.
I don't. I don't enjoy myself at all. Oh, I'm sick of being discreet when everyone knows anyway. I'm sick of wondering what the hell you see in me. I'm sick of worrying about someone younger and smarter coming along and... You're no use. You can't even tell me a few lies to cheer me up. You don't even want to think about it, do you?
Doesn't seem to be doing you much good.
Look... I was married to Bill for 17 years. I didn't didn't run around having affairs. I mean, there were one or two blokes before I was married, but I've forgotten what it was like to just...